To summarize for you some of the highlights, because I wouldn't be able to tell you everything in detail, but to summarize some of the highlights of this session. First, let me address the global mitigation framework. There is a growing realization and acknowledgement that resolving the future of the Kyoto Protocol is an essential task this year. And will require high-level political guidance, but that it is also part of the bigger mitigation picture. The Kyoto Protocol remains fundamental and critical for at least two reasons. One, that it contains the key rules to quantify and monitor the mitigation efforts of countries. And secondly, of course, that it contains the important market-based mechanisms that allows those countries to reach their mitigation levels at a cost-effective level. A central political question this session has been crystallized in the sense of focusing on how will further emission reduction commitments by developed countries be taken forward in the broader context of the emerging climate regime. Governments are realizing that the link between mitigation under the convention and under the protocol needs to be dealt with in order to come to a global solution, and it is precisely that link that is going to require high-level political attention during this year. At the same time, the possibility of a regulatory gap between the first commitment period and a second commitment period is looming in front of governments. At present, they're still discussing how to deal with this, but it is very clear that by the end of this year, i.e. by Durban, they need to come forward with options that are going to be acceptable to all parties. Let me then move to the carpentry side, which is the implementation infrastructure that was in principle agreed to in Cancun, but that needs much more development throughout this year. This session has been particularly fruitful on many of those issues. The Adaptation Committee, the purpose of which is to promote implementation of stronger adaptation action during these 2 weeks. There has been stronger convergence on how the institution will be governed, what its composition would be, and how to interpret its role as the advisory body on adaptation to the Conference of the Parties. That means that the Adaptation Committee is actually on track to be operationalized in Durban. The same goes for the technology mechanism that has had quite a bit of concrete progress during these 2 weeks at this session. Governments have made progress there on defining the center and network, and they have asked the Secretariat to draw up and keep a record of stakeholders that will be interested in participating. Again, with the intent of the technology mechanism, as per the Cancun agreements, to become fully operational in the year 2012. On the Green Climate Fund, which is going to be the center for financial management of the future climate regime, the design of the fund itself is in the hands of the Transitional Committee. They have already had two meetings and are scheduled for a third one in July in Tokyo. And there is already some good advance on the standing committee that will actually be able to keep a broader overview of all of the climate finance flows, and which is within the negotiating track here in this formal process.